Hello, I'm Chris Williams from Read Comics, They're Bad for You, the name of my YouTube channel. If you're watching this on Library when I have it up and running finally, thank you for subscribing. If you're watching this on BitChute, please subscribe to my BitChute channel, Comic Freak. We're going to be talking about recent news with Warcraft 3 Reforged, some of it funny and some of it very sad, so come along with me and read these articles and statements from Blizzard regarding what has happened with their new game, or should I say this mess that they meant to be a game. Here we have a statement from Blizzard. Hail, War 3 players. We've been following the discussion the past couple of days and want to thank you for your feedback as well as your support. First off, we want to say we're sorry to those of you who didn't have the experience you wanted, and we'd like to share our plans for what's coming next. Here's the usual spin doctoring from Blizzard, and they're trying to, well, say everything's all right even though everything's burning down around them. There were a few hours during launch day where we experienced severe load issues that impacted players' ability to jump right in, but we were able to resolve those later in the day. Separate from that, we've seen community feedback about different aspects of Reforged that we wanted to take some time to address. Before we go on, the team is excited that Warcraft 3 Reforged is finally upon us, and we're fully committed to supporting the game for a long time to come. The next few patches and updates will discuss below are just part of our ongoing plans. This game is an integral part of the Blizzard DNA with a team that loves Warcraft 3, and we're looking forward to pouring our hearts into Reforged and the Warcraft 3 community for the long term. So you fixed those server load issues, huh? From what I hear, people who are trying to play the game are still basically waiting on the loading page to play the game, or in the game lobby apparently, and not being able to actually access any of the features. Here's another issue. One of the concerns with Reforged that we've seen are the visuals when selecting Classic Mode. We've identified the bug causing the colors and shading to look different from the original Warcraft 3, and we're testing a fix that will be incorporated in a large patch addressing this issue and others. We expect to release this late this week. This patch will also address many other known issues, such as fixing some portrait animations and audio bugs, implementing some UI fixes, and more. Please keep an eye out for the patch notes for the detailed lists of all the bug fixes. You say you're fixing the issues with the game, but let's look at that article from Polygon addressing some of the issues people have with the game. Warcraft 3 Reforged has not had a good first week, with player complaints that the game changed too much and rampant technical issues. The relaunch isn't living up to Warcraft 3's illustrious legacy. Seemingly aware of the game's flaws, Blizzard is now offering instant refunds for Warcraft 3 Reforged via tickets on its website. According to fans on the subreddit, Blizzard support will grant players a refund regardless of how much time they've spent on the game. User Kryonic LTD played the final version of Warcraft 3 Reforged for over 5 hours and still received a refund without issue. Many other users in the comments section echoed how easy the process was and confirmed their ability to refund the game using the link above. Players are unhappy with Warcraft 3 Reforged for a number of reasons, most of which are laid out on the damning Warcraft 3 Refunded website. Players feel Blizzard broke many of its original promises, such as the cutscenes quality of campaign overhauls. In our experience, the game hasn't lived up to the quality we experienced at BlizzCon 2018. We originally praised the game for how different it was from the original, but after launch, it seems Blizzard went a safer, less interesting route, leading to player dissatisfaction. So you can see from this article here, you can tell pretty much all the spin doctoring from the statement from Blizzard they're doing. It was just a way for Blizzard to buy time and basically hope that, well, alleviate some of the criticism they're getting from people who are basically screaming at them. But let's get back to that statement Blizzard issued. Another area of concern we're seeing is regarding online features such as leaderboards and clans, which applies to all Warcraft 3 players, including those who haven't purchased Reforged at BlizzCon. We talked a lot about how the team is actively working on standing up the back end to ensure a smooth transition to this new MMR system, much like we did with StarCraft Remastered. As with Remastered, these and other features will be included in a major patch for Reforged, which will also address the issue for players of the original game. We'll share release plans as work progresses in the coming weeks. Please be assured that the team is hard at work on standing these features up. there are some individual concerns we've seen that we're not currently planning to address, and we wanted to give the community a heads up as of version 1.30 of the original game. We saw very low usage of tournaments in the Reign of Chaos rule set, so we removed both in mid-2019 and version 1.31, eliminating the maintenance for underused elements, and has helped us streamline our overall support of the game and focus on areas impacting the most players. That said, we do anticipate that players who prefer Reign of Chaos will find custom games with similar rule sets, which we hope will help satisfy that concern. So you're not going to give the one thing that these players wanted to have, huh? And you're saying, go play a different game that is similar to it. Oh, that is so nice of you, Blizzard. No, it is not. A lot of people probably wanted to play that game just to play Reign of Chaos, but you're not giving it to them. You literally bait and switched your players. You promised them one thing, and you gave them something completely different. Related to that, as we talked about last year at BlitzCon, we did not want the in-game cutscenes to steer too far from the original game. We went a little deeper into the thought process behind that at the show, but the main takeaway is that the campaigns tell one of the classic stories in Warcraft history, and we want to preserve the true spirit of Warcraft 3 and allow players to relive these unforgettable moments as they were built with new animations and higher fidelity art. We know this update doesn't address all questions, but we're committed to the development and support of this game. We hope you'll keep an eye out for this week's patch and future updates, and let us know what you think as we continue fine-tuning things. Until then, thank you as always for your support and passion for Warcraft 3. We appreciate all your feedback and will continue to keep the Warcraft 3 community updated on everything we're working on. Sincerely, the Warcraft 3 Reforged team. But you promised players that the lore in the game would be remodeled to fit the modern lore that Warcraft has become. You promised to reanimate and give new cutscenes, but you haven't done that. That's not preserving the original game. That's completely going back on the promise you made back at BlitzCon 2018 when you'd said you'd do all of this. Instead, you release a buggy game that has none of the features you promised, and you say this is Warcraft 3 Reforged, and a much better game than what came out 20 years ago. But no, it's not. You gave them a mess. And here's what happened to your stocks, Blizzard, the day after you released this game. Here's January 31st, and as you can see, it plunges down as your stock crashes because you've angered your fan base and buying base. You know, your consumers, and considering how your stock is just plunging down, wow, really, really far, I have to say you've really done a number, and I have to say this looks absolutely horrible from a business standpoint, because wow. Not to mention the fact that you now own custom map ownership. Blizzard clearly isn't risking another Dota getting away from them, buried away in Warcraft 3 Reforged Terms of Service as a clause that gives them total ownership of any custom maps created by users, including mortal rights. Custom games are and shall remain the sole exclusive property of Blizzard, without limiting the foregoing, and you herbally assign to Blizzard all of your rights, title, and interest in and to all customer games, including but not limited to any copyrighted in the content of any custom games, to the extent you are prohibited from transferring or assigning your moral rights to Blizzard by applicable laws to the utmost. Extent legally permitted, you waive any moral rights or similar rights you may have in all such custom games without any remuneration. Remember this before I go forward. Blizzard is only claiming ownership of all these custom games created with their content creator because they want to own the next Dota 2. As I've said before, Dota, the original game that preceded Dota 2, was created with their content, but because they didn't claim ownership of it, Valve was able to make Dota 2 and basically owns one of the premier esports in the world. But now that Blizzard is claiming ownership of all these custom games, they're now the proud owners of a bunch of racist and far out there games that are created just for parody and fun on their game creator. But now they're facing, well, backlash from it because people are now saying that they promote racism and misogyny. And what can I say? All I can say is that it's richly deserved that Blizzard is getting all this heat now because of what they've done. If you like this video, subscribe. Make sure you're still subscribed because YouTube is going around unsubscribing people, so make sure you're still subscribed. If you're watching my videos but you're not subscribed, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, Read Comics, They're Bad For You. Then go over to BitChute and subscribe to my BitChute channel, Comic Freak. Hit that bell for notifications, hit that like button, and leave some comments down below. And if you could you also please share this video? Share it on Twitter, share it on Reddit, and share it on Facebook. Share it anywhere you think it'll do the most good, because I really want you to share my videos so everyone can see them. So please share my videos. Now listen closely, keep checking back in all my future videos for more information on my own upcoming independent comic book Scum Dogs. I'm Chris Williams, and I'll be back again tomorrow with another video or review.